Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. Exercise 1.3, question number 6 and 7 solution. Show that f is a function defined from minus 1 to 1 to r given by f of x is equal to x divided by x plus 2 is 1 1. Find the inverse of the function f defined from minus 1 comma 1 to range of f. See here, r means it is the set of real numbers. So here they have asked us to show that this function is 1, 1. To show any function as 1, 1, we have to take first of all f of x1 is equal to f of x2. Then here if we get x1 is equal to x2, then we can say that the function is 1, 1. So now let us try to show that this function is 1, 1. So first of all here I will take any two numbers from the domain. For this function f of x, they have given the domain as minus 1, 1 and the codomain as real number. So let us take two numbers, x1 and x2 belongs to the domain, that is x1, x2 belongs to minus 1, 1. Now from the definition of the function, for these each of these values, we can define a function. F of x1 is equal to x1 divided by x1 plus 2. F of x2 is equal to x2 divided by x2 plus 2. Now if f of x1 is equal to f of x2, then we can have x1 divided by x1 plus 2 is equal to x2 divided by x2 plus 2. Now you can cross multiply here, x1 into x2 plus 2 is equal to x2 into x1 plus 2. That is x1 into x2 plus 2x1 is equal to x1 into x2 plus 2x2. This and this will get cancelled. So we have here 2x1 is equal to 2x2. Then 2 and 2 you can cancel. So we get here finally x1 is equal to x2. See, here we have taken f of x1 is equal to f of x2 and finally we got x1 is equal to x2. That means now we can say the function is 1, 1. Next, in the question, they have asked us to find the inverse of the function. So here we need to find the inverse of the function. Generally, see how we find the inverse of any function. For example, let us say that here one function is given y is equal to f of x. The function have some values like 1, 2, 3, 4 like this way. Now here for this particular 1 we have the image 3, for 2 we have the image 4. So directly we can say that here f of 1 is equal to 3 and f of 2 is equal to 4. But if I want to find the inverse of this, that is nothing but the pre-image of 3 and pre-image of 4, which is f inverse of 3. F inverse of 3 is 1 and f inverse of 4 is 2. Like this way, we can find the inverse. So when we find the inverse, codomain become the domain and domain become the range. So now here, if you have y is equal to f of x, then we can have the inverse as f inverse of y is equal to x. Like in this case, see, f of 1 is equal to 3. Then to get this value, we can write f inverse of 3 is equal to 1, or f of 2 is equal to 4, or f inverse of 4 is equal to 2. So this is the way of finding the inverse. So here we need to find the inverse. See, here when they have given the function is written in terms of x. This f of x is nothing but the y value. So we have a function which is written in terms of x. So y is written in terms of x. Now here we have to find the function x so that that value must be written in terms of y. So we have y is equal to x divided by x plus 2. You just cross multiply. Y into x plus 2 is equal to x. Yx plus 2y is equal to x. So 2y, take this to this side. X minus yx. So 2y is equal to x, you can take common. X into 1 minus y. That is x is equal to 2y divided by 1 minus y. So here you can see that we have a function which is written in terms of y. X value is written in terms of y. This forms the inverse of the function f of x, which we can write as f inverse of y, or you can use here a new function name like g of y. I am taking here g of y is equal to 2y divided by 1 minus y. But in this case, see, here we have got 2y divided by 1 minus y. You have to write one condition. The condition is that suppose here y value is equal to 1, 1 minus 1. That means we get here something divided by 0. Something divided by 0 is always undefined, which gives the answer infinity. That is not possible. So you have to write the condition as y is not equal to 1. So this is the inverse of the function f of x, which we denote as f inverse of y. Then when we find the inverse, domain and codomain value changes. See, at the beginning they have given for this function the domain is minus 1, 1, and then see here they have given the domain value is minus 1, 1, and then codomain value is r. Now here the domain value for the inverse function, we can write the domain as this and codomain as this. But here we have seen that the condition we have written, the condition is that for y is equal to 1, we can't define this function. So we should have here y is not equal to 1. That means we can define a new domain value for the inverse function as g is a function defined from r minus 1, set of real numbers. From that you have to exclude 1, then to minus 1 comma 1. So like this way you can define the domain and codomain of the function. That is the reason that see in the question they have given f is a function defined from minus 1 to 1, then to range of f. They have given here range of f, they have not given just r here, because when we find the inverse we get one condition where y is not equal to 1. If y value is equal to 1, then we can't have the inverse here. If y value is equal to 1, then this particular function is not going to define. It gives the answer as infinity. That is the reason that they have given in the question itself the codomain value as range f. Question number 7. Consider f is a function defined from r to r given by f of x is equal to 4x plus 3. Show that f is invertible. Find the inverse of f. So here they have asked us to show that the function is invertible. We can show any function is invertible if it is 1,1 and onto. So first here we have to check for 1,1 and onto. So if the function is 1,1 as well as onto, that means if the function is bijective, then we can say that the function is invertible. Then we can find the inverse of the function, and further we can verify that whatever the inverse we have got, that is correct or not, by finding the fog and gop value. So now let us start doing the solution. So they have given the function f of x is equal to 4x plus 3. Now the first step is we have to check for 1,1 and onto. We know that for 1,1 we have the condition. We have to take f of x1 is equal to f of x2. Then if that gives x1 is equal to x2, then we call the function as 1,1. So now let us take any two values from the domain. That is x1, x2 belongs to R. Then from the definition of the function, for x1 we can have f of x1 as f of x1 is equal to 4x1 plus 3, and for x2 f of x2 is equal to 4x2 plus 3. Suppose if f of x1 is equal to f of x2, then we can have f of 4x1 plus 3 is equal to 4x2 plus 3. So this 3 and 3 we can cancel. So we have 4x1 is equal to 4x2. Then this 4 and 4 we can cancel. So we have here x1 is equal to x2. See here I have taken f of x1 is equal to f of x2, and finally I have got x1 is equal to x2. That means now we can say the function is 1,1. Next here we have to check for the onto. So to check for the onto here, first of all the function is there in terms of x. So y value is written in terms of x. So we have to write a function which is in terms of y. So x value you have to write in terms of y. So that step you have to do. So we have the function f of x is equal to 4x plus 3. F of x we can take as y. So y is equal to 4x plus 3. Now here we have a function which is written in terms of x. The y value is written as in terms of x. So now you need to find the function where you have to get the x value, that is in terms of y. So take this 3 to this side. So y minus 3 is equal to 4x. X is equal to y minus 3 divided by 4. So you can see that here we have got the value that is nothing but written in terms of y. The x value is written in terms of y. And here this is nothing but the rational real number only. So here we can see that this belongs to the real number set. Now you put this x value here in this function. Then let us see whether we get f of x is equal to y or not. So we have f of x is equal to 4 into x is this one. So 4 into y minus 3 divided by 4 plus 3. This 4 and 4 will get cancelled. So we have y minus 3 plus 3. So 3 and minus 3 get cancelled. So we get the answer y. So we got here f of x is equal to y. That means now here we can say that for every y belongs to the R, there exists a x is equal to y minus 3 divided by 4 belongs to R such that f of x is equal to y. Here we have got that f of x is equal to y means for every image in the codomain, we have a pre-image in the domain. So we can say the function is onto. So now we have got the function is onto as well as 1, 1. That means this shows that the function is invertible. So since the function is 1, 1 and onto, that means it is a bijective function. We can say that here the inverse of the function exists and the function is invertible. And we can write the inverse of the function as f inverse of y is equal to g of y, that is equal to this value that already we have got, that is y minus 3 divided by 4. And now for this we can define the range and codomain as R to R. In this case there is no change, domain and codomain as R to R. In this case there is no change in the domain and codomain, as in the definition of the function they have given domain and codomain both as real numbers. So now we got that the function is invertible and also we got the inverse. This inverse you can verify whether we have got the correct answer or not by again further checking, that is for Goff and Fogg. That is here Goff and Fogg is equal to the identity function. So you need to find out the Goff value and Fogg value. Here f is the original function which is given and g is the inverse function. So composition of the function we have to do now. So let us do that. So here we have two functions. F is a function defined from R to R. F of x is equal to 4x plus 3. Then we got the inverse g of y is equal to y minus 3 divided by 4. So first we will find Goff, that is g of f of x. That is inside this g function we have to write the x value as f of x. So we have this g function. Here wherever you have y, replace that as wherever you have y, replace that as f of x. So f of x minus 3 divided by 4. That is equal to, we know the value of f of x, that is 4x plus 3. Just put that value, 4x plus 3 minus 3 divided by 4. This 3 and 3 will get cancelled. So we get 4x divided by 4. After cancellation, we get here x. So we got here Goff of x is equal to x. Next here you need to find out the Fogg. So Fogg of y, that is f of g of y is equal to, see f of g of y means here the function f we have 4x plus 3. In the place of x here you have to put g of y. That means 4 into g of y plus 3. Then we know the value of g of y, that is y minus 3 divided by 4. That you have to replace here. So 4 into y minus 3 divided by 4 plus 3. That gives the answer as y minus 3 plus 3. After cancellation we get here y. So we got here Fogg of y, that is f of g of y is equal to y. So for this x, here we are taking the input as x, for that we got x, and here we are taking the input as y and we got here y. That means both of these are identity function. So we can say here Goff is equal to Fogg is equal to IR. The IR is nothing but the domain value. In this case the domain is real number in both the cases. So now here even we can say that the function is invertible and the f inverse is nothing but here f inverse of y, that is equal to g of y is equal to y minus 3 divided by 4. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Thanks for watching.